Hey, Jalen, see all this excess that's going to end up? We need to wipe that off. Not inside the hole, but on the outside of the hole.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Just on the outside. You can't. You might have to. Here, just come, go, come get inside the boat. I'm going to move out your way in just a minute. Make sure you don't step in the stuff I just did.
On the other side.
Yeah, here, you can get the backside while you're there. Because look, watch what's going to happen. Right here, watch. See all of it just coming out the... You might have to throw it. If that rag gets too wet, you might have to throw it away and get another one. You know, I didn't get any of it. Wherever you see pooling drops, you need to wipe it up, because otherwise we'll have to sand it later. You might have to put, it might be easier too to put a little bit of acetone on your rag. Maybe, it might be. Now it's wiping up without the acetone. Make sure you don't wipe in the hole, just on the outside of the hole, because you want the resin inside the hole to stay. Okay, now we got to keep checking the hole, because see, like right here where you wiped it and it came back, so we got to keep checking to make sure until it starts to dry, then it's okay. It won't run anymore. Normally, you want your smallest piece of cloth to go down first, and then your next piece will overlap, 3 or 4 inches, and your next piece will overlap 3 or 4 inches. Well, the reason you saw this one done out of order is because I wasn't planning on adding no more than just that one. I was going to throw that, I peanut buttered the piece to the floor, and then I was going to put one piece of 1708 over it. Well, I was looking at some pictures of my boat, like it was before, and that piece sat a little higher off the bottom, so I thought I'd lay two layers of 1708 and a layer of chop strand over it. And it was just, it wasn't about waterproofing or strength, it was just about trying to raise it up a little bit without putting another slab of wood on it. And so it was like a compromise. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let that thoroughly kick. I'm going to, me and my nephew, we've been coming around wiping off, because when you stick that resin in these holes, I mean, it makes a big pooling mess. So we had some rags, and we were going around, and just kept on wiping it. Hey Jay, there's a, can you come wipe this? There's a little, we gotta keep checking these holes every couple minutes, because if you don't wipe it off now, you're gonna have to sand it. So anyway, back to this. So everywhere, all these transom holes, we're gonna have to, I'm checking them on the outside too, to make sure there's nothing leaking. See, I see some, there's some leaks out here too, Jay. Just check them all real quick. Don't step in the work, please. And so, we wanna make sure that's, so we don't have to sand that later. Just those holes. So anyway, that's what that was about. We're gonna let this kick, we're gonna go make a stand real quick for the outdrive, to set the outdrive on, and we're gonna pressure test it. And then we're gonna come back to the boat and get this thing ready. It's almost ready to gel coat. I threw a piece of chop strand on the booger up there. I did. I just threw a piece on there, and I'm gonna sand it down. You can see it's sticking up. I just wanted to put a little slab of piece on there. But anyway, I'm gonna sand it down, make it even after it dries. We got all of the holes resin. We got the transom holes resin. I'm gonna get some acetone, come back and wipe this keyhole, and then we'll go from there.